This is a three-jaw chuck for my small lathe. This back plate is what adjusts the jaws, and it has a single hole for using a jimmy bar. I bought an apparatus for counting the number of turns that this makes. It runs a magnet past a Hall effect sensor, so I needed a way to mount that magnet to this chuck. So I made this. Fits on the chuck quite firmly, and there's a pocket in here for that magnet, and that's just pressed in there. And then this is a hole that will line up with that hole for the jimmy bar. And if it's too loose, I have a threaded hole over here where I can put a set screw. So we just need to put this together like this. And that jimmy bar will go in there. I'm going to be using this to count the number of turns that I'm putting on an electric coil, and this won't be turning very fast. This counter comes with a Hall effect sensor in this bracket. I have a steel plate back here behind the lathe bed, and I have this mounted onto this magnet. I have this Hall effect sensor adjusted as close to this magnet as I can get it without it hitting. When that magnet goes by that sensor, it wakes up the display. Count every time the magnet goes by. This comes with instructions. Every bit of it's in Chinese, absolutely useless to me. So you just have to mess around with this until you figure out how it works. I know this will zero the counter, and if you hold this down long enough, it'll power off. I'm going to be winding this coil, and I need to wind six of these. This is for an experimental generator I'm trying to build. I need to wind these as close to each other as possible, and that's the reason for this counter. This unit has a single AA battery in it. You can power this off, or if it goes without use, it will time out and turn itself off. I expect this will be about as fast as this is running when I'm winding. I made another gadget here that will attach to here with double-sided tape. This turns on an ungreased roller skate bearing, and it holds my spool of wire. It turns very freely. Before I start winding with that real fine wire, I thought I'd practice with some string. I've started the wire on the spool, turned on the counter. Now we just start winding. I'm wrapping the coil with tape. I want to keep the beginning and the ending leads separate.